know it wasn't easy, but this could really be a turning point in our research. Not only can we interrogate the subject, but bringing an alien back alive provides us with a much better understanding of their physiology. Impressive work indeed. Preparations in the containment facility are well underway.
Remember, we will be watching.
We should begin interrogating the alien subject immediately. I'm confident we can safely house it within the containment facility, but I can't say for how long.
Twisted hulk of flesh and metal, driven by the alien technology, can we still call that life? We have to keep moving forward with the project, but the thought of treading the same path as the aliens is troubling. What if they were like us once? Are we just part of a continuing cycle? If this is a glimpse of our future, I want no part of it.
At least we know where they are. been spent.
Ah, damn it.
Hell. Weapons empty. Can't engage.
The alien flight computer could prove to be extremely useful in our own research. Please take great care in returning it to the base in one piece.
So, how'd it go, Doctor?
Better than expected. Before the creature expired, I was able to extract some new information from it.
You're saying that thing spoke to you?
Not precisely. But when you have access to a creature's brain, certain patterns can be discerned. Recent images and thoughts.
And what exactly was our late friend thinking about?
This particular image appeared in the creature's thought pattern several times throughout the procedure.
We've already met that thing, Doctor. This is hardly the kind of breakthrough we were...
And there was a neural link in the creature's mind between this image and this one.
That's the thing that pulled a disappearing act when we shot down our first UFO. And let me guess, you want to poke around in its head too.
It is the next piece of the puzzle. And this time, instead of shooting it, I suggest we try to capture it alive. We should be focused on capturing this strange alien creature, the one that seemed to form around the crystal we discovered when we shot down the first UFO. It's all we have to go on at the moment.
In times of war, there's always a leader, a general, someone giving the orders. These aliens can be no different. The real question is, what sort of power or authority does it take to control such a vast range of alien species? What incentive will they have to follow through with this plan?
Another contact. The signature is a little bigger this time, though. Bangs out.
Satellite assisted targeting enabled.
Get ready to deploy. Our AO is within the continental United States. It looks like the aliens went down in a sparsely populated area. If there are civilians in the area, I hope they stay clear.
Central, this is Big Sky. Strike One is ready to secure the craft.
Copy, Big Sky. Strike One is clear to attempt the breach.
Something.